Buddy go. Welcome to my bomb shelter. In case this doesn't work out, you become the bomb shelter. I know that you're going to be up over the here with high water by the time you get through this whole affair. But I'm very grateful to the directors of these events. They included me on the list for you to come by and see my efforts. I know in the group many acquaintances who, during the past year or year and a half, have said that Buddy Cole is a big snob slob, a big antisocial bum. Why doesn't he invite us over to see what's going on over here? Well, the answer is that I just hated to be apologizing and making excuses for things. I'm right. But time runs out. So here we are, and I still have all my excuses and apologies for things that I'm not right. I planned originally, before I knew it was going to be a large group, to have the chairs in here for you. And I know it's a little inconvenient standing, but I'll be as brief as possible, as explicit and painless, I hope. And we'll get this over with right away. But I did want to tell you a few things that I have thought may be interesting to you. The installation of this organ is something that it's pretty hard to really go into detailed explanation about. But I will say that anyone, rich man, poor man, that's me, a man living in 4 ranks or 44 ranks or 5 ranks, anyone who can attempt it and get playing really deserves a lot of credit. Speaking of credit, I couldn't let this moment go by without us telling you of the 3 people involved besides myself in this little venture. One who was rather inactive as far as the actual installation of the organ, but was very active and seeing to it that I did. I sat around for about 3 years with the organ in storage, and my dear sweet wife said, "We've got to do it. Go see the bank, dig the hole, put up the building, install the organ." She knows that I love the thing and praise God and desire to keep it out of the bars at night. Aside from that, well, she's very good, and she holds notes while I tune. You gotta beat them a little bit, but they'll do it. Every board, every nail, every screw, everything that's behind this facade that you see, is installed by just 2 people. Myself, a little guy by the name of Buster Ross. Buster with us today, by any chance.
Where's Buster?
Well, he's not here. He has quite a name for himself. It was difficult to get along. I found that with the right brand of vodka and the right amount, with a few good words, he worked like this. And I helped out a little bit there, so between us, we managed to get all this mess out of the floor and back inside. Now, along with this, there's a man who has been like a second father to me. I've known him since I was 13 years old. I started playing in theater in Los Angeles. And I traveled with him. I learned what little I know about the mechanics of pipe organ from him. God knows I didn't learn enough, finding it out. But he's not only a great technician, but one of the finest men I have ever met. Of course, that's Henry Pope, and I'm sure you'll have heard that before. Unfortunately, when the time came to start finishing the unfinishable and getting the thing tuned up and working on it, Henry's doctors told him to take a rest. So we all have been having to do that for a long time, and he just finally had to do it. Of course, I was included on the list, he couldn't be working his head off here. It's very unfortunate for me, but I was very fortunate in remembering the name that the late Joe Kearns gave me. Call me, said, "Buddy, for heaven's sake, call this man. He's a very dedicated boy to the organ work. And I'm sure you'll get along with him and he will just do you the world of good." Well, this guy came to my rescue. And I know that he will go as far as it's possible to go in the organ business. His name is Don Polis. I know that Don is in this group tonight. Don told me a great deal, so we're getting along with the excuses. But aside from the things that are wrong, the obvious things in the console and back in the back, there's another side of the scripture, some of the things that I'm very proud of. They worked out, I don't know how. I wanted them to work that way, but I didn't design them, it just worked out. I installed this organ for one main purpose, and that was for organ stereo recording. Of course, this opens up a whole can of worms when you mention stereo. This is a whole other subject. And I can't get into that except to tell you that I know from experimenting for the past year and a half, the pipe organ is one of the greatest things for stereo recording. But you have to have all the component parts for it. First, I was lucky in getting a building with reverberation. Now, of course, it will not reverberate when it has this many people. But when I'm just here alone recording with it, I get about a 4-second decay in the sound. This is really necessary for good stereo, besides the installation, which is not necessarily unique. And the organs have been installed like this before. I was very lucky with the room sound to gain this stereo quality I have been able to get. In the organ itself, I've enlarged the shutter so that everything speaks out, nothing is hidden. To this organ, I added 9 ranks of the organ that I had in my other home. Robert Norton job that many of you probably remember the record I made years ago, which I did not forget. But I added 9 ranks. I divided it between the chambers so that the stereo recording, I get a beautiful, spacious sound of it. Not my playing, I'm trying to record it. For example, I put the Morton flute over in the solo, I have the Wurlitzer flute on this side. I have the Wurlitzer trumpet over here, I have the Morton trumpet over here. I have the Wurlitzer dulciana on the main, and the Morton dulciana here, and so on forth on down the line. The tribute from the Morton here, the tribute from the Wurlitzer here. Therefore, in recording stereo, not all of a sudden this full organ come out of one side of the speaker. It is spread across. And then, of course, the new gag of putting the percussions up in the center so that they're right in the center of the recording. Well, these are some things that I've got. The instrument, I've got a long way to go yet. And I guess I can't get out of playing the damn thing. There's no way I can. Set up, those of you on the solo side are going to get a little more on the solo and be more aware of that close to me. But maybe if you back up a little bit, I think maybe you'll get a little better sound of the organ. And we'll try. Honey, push the button.